We are from the Awal Project Group 26. So today we are going to do our reflection video on our first the Awal Project, which is makeup organizer. So as usual, we are going to introduce ourselves, and I'm going to start first. Okay, my name is Muhammad Fikir Shazlan bin Sa'ad, and my matrix number is 192524, and I am from course of biomedical science, which is first year, and I am from faculty of medical and science health. I come from foundation of agriculture and science. I live in Pahang, which is Kuala Lumpur. I think that's all. I'm going to
Good morning and
assalamualaikum.
My name is Anissa binti Yusof. My matric number is 192603, and I'm from Bachelor of Nursing first year, and I'm from Taiping Perak, and I also graduate from Asasi Sains Pertanian UPN.
Good morning and assalamualaikum. My name is Nur Alia Balkis binti Dahlan. You can call me Alia. I'm a dietetics first year student of Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences. Yes, that one. I come from Jakarta. I graduated from Asasi Sains Pertanian UPN.
Good morning. Hi, my name is Nur Fatia binti Muhammad Suhaimi. My matric number is 191888. I am the first year of course Nutrition and Community Health. I was graduated from Foundation of Agriculture Science, UPM. And that's all for me. Okay, hi, my name is Nur Imanina Izzati. My matrix number is 194393. I'm taking dietetics first year in Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences. I'm from Bidan Negeri Sembilan, and I was graduated from SSC Science, so I think I'm
Hi and good morning everyone. My name is Nur Shafiqah binti Muhammad. My matric number is 192384. I am a nursing student. I am on my first year. I am also graduated from Asasi Sains Pertanian UPN.
Hi everyone, I'm Ng Pi Chen and I'm from STPN.
Hi everyone, I'm Ng Pi Chen and my matrix number is 193300, and I'm a first year student of the dietetics course from Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences, and my hometown is Taiping Perak. I'm previously graduate from SMJK Hualien Taiping.
Hi everyone, so my name is Chiao Ailun. So my matric number is 194737. Recently, I'm the first year student of Bachelor of Environmental Management. I'm from Ipoh, Perak, and previously I'm just graduated from Polish Ikatan Alumni Sri Putra as taking a STPM.
Hi everyone, my name is Chen Zixin. You can call me Chen. My matric number is 194027. And currently, I'm a first year student of dietetic courses in Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences. And I come from KL, and I was a STPM student from College Tingkata Unam Desai.
Okay, hi everyone. My name is Sunita. And my matric number is 194851. Currently, I'm studying dietetic course in Faculty Medicine and Health Science. Then I'm origin from Kelantan. I previously graduated from Perak Matriculation College.
So, we are going to start with the reflection on the DIY project of makeup organizer box. Okay, first in first, because I am a boy, for me, a makeup organizer is not a thing So I think this box can be used to a different purpose. Okay, first we have the small box and the upper box, which can be used to put my, how you call it, stationary equipment such as pencil or liquid. I can also put small book like notebook and also small paper notes that I get from my lecturer. After that, I can also use it as to put my grooming set, which is like a comb or hair gel, even a deodorant. Because in the Polish, there is not provided a place to put all your grooming set. After that, I can also use it as a place to put my fork and spoon. I know it's a bit, it will be damaged because of the water, but it can be improved by putting a plastic cover which is waterproof and it can protect the box and increase the severity. I think that's all.
Okay, next, other than using this as a makeup organizer, I can also put my electronic devices such as my power bank, my handphone, my cables, my laptop charger here so that my table will be more organized. I can also put my makeup.
You can improve this part by putting I think cardboard and try to put some, what I call it, like hangers,
hang your key. My room key.
Okay, for me, I will use this to put my medicine such as Yakamat. Apart from that, I also can put my comb, my what you call compact powder, and others.
Okay. As for me, this is like a life savior for the person that loves to buy more makeups. Okay, so that I can like put all of my makeup here because it's quite big and as girls we love lipstick, right? So we can put like more lipstick and yeah, our makeup is like huge, like a priority for us. So this is your life savior, so you need to make it out and don't waste your money to buy like expensive makeup vanity, because this is just nice. And when you it also safe place when you're staying in college. You know that the locker is so small, so this will save your space and you can put it anywhere without your table looking mess. Okay, that's all for me.
Okay, for me, I can use this to put my grooming set. As for me, I don't have many makeups, lipstick and all those things. So I think I can put combs here and little powder here and the deodorants and the lipstick here. But besides that, maybe I can put my toothbrush and my toothpaste here, and maybe like he said, use the plastic cover that are not water soluble. They are waterproof. So yeah, I think you can put also the soap. Yes, so thank you.
Okay, first of all, I am happy with our project. And because I think with this space, big space, I can put my iPad here and all of the softening, foundation, mascara. And what is unique about our project is for example, I want to add one more compartment to put my makeup construction, so I can stick any box that I have read with this library paper. And for example, I can put here or back here. So we can add more space anytime, anywhere we want. So I think it is a flexible product, so I am happy with it. And we can improve the appearance by changing the wrapping paper with the waterproof wrapping paper, so you want the niche easily, so you can add more glitter or furry things here to make it more girlish. And so I'm happy with it.
This is the DIY project of our makeup organizer, and I'm satisfied with the project. First of all, we can make our things more organized and have lower chance of losing it, or save our space and save times for finding those items, small items like hairbands and maybe our cleanser, face cleanser. And I want to make some reflection about our project. For example, every member shows their commitment by giving ideas and provide some useful materials. The talks help us to improve our English proficiency as we need to conduct our project in fully English. And we have an enjoyable moment by arranging the makeup in the boxes after our we have an enjoyable moment when we arrange the makeup after we done the makeup organizer. And I'm looking forward for a more attractive and interesting next DIY project. Thanks for the cooperation and from all members. Thank you.
Okay, now my turn. For me, I will use it for a multi-purpose shelf actually. I'm not using much makeup cosmetic things, so I most probably use it as a stationery holders, like the staplers, the book punches, the pens, pencils, something like that, just fill the places, or even I can use to put my electronic gadgets. Actually, there are much improvement I can do with this DIY project. We can add on the compartment tiers more, and depends on the needs of the personnel. And what I can go through this, gain through this DIY project is same like what her say just now, so you can gain some collaborations among the teammates, and I'm glad with that. Thank you.
Okay. Hi, so now it's my turn now. So for me, I also don't use much makeup stuff, so I just use it to put like stationaries and like handphone or keys. And one more, before we go in the bath, we need to take off our bag, right? So I will put inside there. And I would like to add one more point for improvement, we can put a cover to cover this section so that to prevent dust from going inside. And then from this DIY project, I also learned that cooperation is very important.
Now it's my turn. For me, I will use I will divide it into two parts. Here I can put my stationery set, my pencil, my everything. Then for this part, I can put the cream, face cream, or the hairbands, or small accessory that we can easily find when we need it in emergency or something, so it will save our times and make the our tables more organized. Yeah. Okay, that's all for me.
Obstacle when we're doing this makeup organizer, the most obviously one is while we are start doing this, we are lacking of planning. We're not even plan where to put boxes, small boxes, and how to wrap things actually. And also we didn't plan about where we need to put the compartment actually. So there are much improvement that we can do while doing this. And are you guys talking about?
I have an idea.
box. If you can feel it, it's a little bit fragile. So when you put your makeups or your things in it, you may use it in weeks, maybe 2 or 3 weeks only, because it's not
solid
solid enough to withstand for a long time. So for improvement, I think we can use cardboard to make it a bit solid, and we can longer the lifespan. So
any idea? Problem when we're using a cardboard, mean we need to purposely buy a hard cardboard to withstand it, but at the same time it will cost, cost will increase, right?
Yes.
So that's why we are using a shoeboard instead of a hard cardboard.
Or maybe we didn't think of the waterproof method, as we can just do a simple task by wrapping off with the our wrapping paper for books, because that is cheaper and more economical compared to maybe buying plastic or using plastic, more difficult to cut.
Apart from using box, make like this, we can use bottle.
Yeah.
So that it will be more stronger to withstand the brush and so on.
Using
waterproof
and recyclable.
Yeah. I have something to add on. Like what we previously did, we just used the wrapping paper to just wrap according to the box. So instead of what we did, we should use the ruler to measure it and make sure the size fits perfectly into the box, so that it will look more neat.
Improve the strength of the object organizer. I think we can use this box, but stick a layer of another box here to make it more stronger. We cut them
double layer,
and so I think it will it will stand more. And I think for this part, as she said, she wants to use water here. I think it's a good idea. And we can use two bottles here with different height here, and spray it with
As for me, because the edges is pointy and it will hurt us, I think we can modify it by using a cotton cloth, so that the edges will not be so sharp and it will be smooth. And
you need to wrap it using a cloth
cotton cloth, so that it will be more soft and not edgy like this.
Okay. I think to make it more effective, other than using only three wrapping papers, we can use any wrapping paper, plain wrapping paper. For this part, other color.
Oh, you mean use different
colors. Combine colors.
So it will be more colorful, and you can add on glitters. You can also write your name here, here to make it nice.
I want to add more. Because this is makeup organizer at first. Maybe you can stick a mirror here. Here is your makeups, and you can just put your makeups in front of this organizer. Just don't need to
make
go
it
to,
depends
yeah.
on your
body.
You can make as a makeup desk.
So we don't have to rush in to take things and
run to the mirror.
Take time.
So just put the mirror here.
To conclude this DIY project, there are some pros and cons on this makeup organizer. First of all, the pros is that not only is a makeup organizer, but it's a multi-purpose box which can be used as many things, for as we mentioned before. And the cons is that because the material that we use are quite fragile and easily to be damaged, and it will cause the survivability to be not sustainable. And after that, the moral in this project is that we learn to work together as a team, and also to be more creative in giving ideas and new ideas to improve the project. So the project is a success, and that's all from us. Thank you.
Bye. Bye.